After months of speculation and leaks, Microsoft has officially revealed Windows 11. Windows 11 is probably not the most substantial update in the last decade, but it's got the potential to be the best one. I know I haven't made a video in a couple months, but with Windows 11, I thought it was a perfect time for me to come back to this channel and go over the biggest changes coming to the update. As for this channel, I really appreciate you guys that have stayed with me, and if this is the first time you're seeing one of my videos, please subscribe to the channel for more Microsoft related videos like this. Now before I get to the biggest changes coming to Windows 11, let's go over the sponsor for this video, Wondershare DemoCreator. DemoCreator is an advanced, easy to use screen recording and video editing software made for all types of content creators, especially YouTubers and Twitch streamers that are just starting out. With just a few clicks, you can easily record yourself and any on-screen activity from gameplay commentaries to full-on presentations. DemoCreator supports real-time screen drawing and spotlight, so you can highlight or focus on a certain area in your tutorial or reaction video. After that, DemoCreator lets you edit your recording in any way that you want. Using the simple yet powerful built-in editor, creators can easily cut footage, add overlaying text, and integrate in transitions into their work. Plus, by taking advantage of some attractive resources and templates from the effects store, creators can do some advanced stuff without being an expert user. DemoCreator gives you a variety of export options and even lets you upload directly to YouTube. If you're interested in being a creator and don't really know where to start, DemoCreator is a great solution since it's both a recording software and an editor. It's free to try, so check out the download link below and take advantage of this channel's exclusive discount. The number one most noticeable change coming to Windows that everyone will notice is a whole new look and feel. Microsoft is bringing their Fluent design language to almost every part of the OS, which means rounded corners, more transparency effects, new icons, and fluid animations. The start menu and the taskbar icons are now all centered, the live tiles are gone, rest in peace, and now Windows will have this simple app launcher with a search bar and recommendations to get users where they need to go faster than ever. The news and interest feed has moved to the side and is now a bit of a dynamic widgets feed. The action center also looks so much better with extra quick actions that'll make it much more usable. The same can be said for tablet mode. While the official tablet mode itself is gone, Windows 11 is built to be more seamless and usable as a tablet. Once you detach the keyboard, the OS will automatically adjust to a touch-friendly UI. There's now touch gestures that mimic the same gestures you do on the touchpad. Vertical snapping is finally a thing, and there are bigger touch targets for launching, moving, or resizing apps in Windows. I said these design changes will come to almost every part of Windows because this OS is decades old underneath that still needs many of its legacy components for backwards compatibility. But it looks like Microsoft is trying harder than before to make this more cohesive, as even File Explorer, Paint, and Notepad are getting new facelifts. Following up on these design changes, the second biggest change is snapping. Snapping has always been the killer feature that has made me stay on Windows all this time, and I love that Microsoft is further improving it. Windows will finally let you snap more than two windows at the same time without you having to manually resize anything. The new Snap Navigator feature is going to let you quickly see the many options of how you can snap and organize all your windows just by hovering over the Maximize button. Then with Snap Groups, Windows remembers how you snapped your apps so you can quickly get back to whatever workflow that you had going on. This is awesome for everyone, but especially for people using external monitors. Before, Windows used to go crazy and resize windows all weirdly when you connect or disconnect a monitor. Now when you disconnect, Windows will remember the snap group and minimize it on your laptop. And once you reconnect, the snap group and all your windows will come right back. Big change number three is the new Microsoft Store, now featuring Android apps. This new store has been rumored for a while, but it's finally official. Really, the most significant part of this new store is that it will actually be useful for most Windows users. The reason is that the new store is completely open for all types of apps, including Win32, PWA, and UWP, without having to be packaged in a certain way by developers. Plus, if you're not a game developer, all developers can keep 100% of sales and in-app revenue by using their own commerce engines within the apps. So all those essential apps that you couldn't find before, like Adobe Creative Cloud, Zoom, and Steam, are really encouraged to get on this new Microsoft Store. With these new changes, the Microsoft Store can truly be the single source for users to find and install all their apps. Now, on the other huge news about the store, Android apps. You'll be able to search for and run Android apps directly on your Windows 11 device. How it works is kind of funky, and because it'll work through the Amazon App Store, through the Microsoft Store. These apps will also be running on Windows using Intel Bridge, which we'll see if these apps actually run well. But the most important thing is that you'll be able to run Android apps on Windows, which could be super useful for some specific use cases. You'll be able to pin them to your taskbar, see them in the start menu, and even snap them side by side with Windows apps. Not all apps from the Amazon App Store will work on Windows, but a Microsoft engineer has confirmed that you'll be able to sideload APKs, so that'll be fun. Number 4, gaming on Windows just got official. Gaming has always been associated with Windows, but they've always been kind of against each other. With Windows 11, Microsoft is adding some really big features that will boost the PC gaming experience. This includes auto HDR that visually enhance all games, even the ones that don't support HDR. There's also going to be direct storage API support, which will significantly reduce game load times for computers with fast SSDs. DirectX 12 Ultimate is coming as well, which includes new features like ray tracing 1.1, variable rate shading, and generally making it easier for game devs to make games. There's also a new version of the Xbox app, which is the biggest deal for me. Game Pass will be directly built into the Xbox app, and that means xCloud will be super accessible from the PC. So no matter how weak or strong your computer is, as long as you have good Wi-Fi, you can play almost any game on Game Pass. I made the full switch to cloud gaming a few months ago, and I think xCloud being widely available like this is probably going to change the gaming industry. Last but not least, number 5, unwanted features are getting dropped and replaced. While killing features might sound like a bad thing, Windows 10 has a lot of baggage, and Windows 11 is an attempt to clean up the OS, replace them with hopefully better things. I already mentioned the live tiles being gone, but Microsoft is also getting rid of the Cortana boot up experience that nobody liked, and also the timeline feature, which nobody used. A lot of unwanted pre-installed apps will be removed by default now, including 3D Viewer, Paint 3D, Internet Explorer, and Skype. Yes, Microsoft is putting Skype to the side, and instead they're pushing Teams, which will be directly integrated into Windows. I don't have high hopes that regular consumers will start using Teams, but this sort of tight integration will make life a lot easier for people who use Teams for work. Another thing going away is the 2 major updates per year cycle that Windows 10 had. Instead, Windows 11 will get 1 major update per year, which will be smaller in size and happen seamlessly in the background. The twice a year update cycle has made things difficult to manage for both Microsoft and its users, so this is definitely a win-win. Plus, this once a year cycle may make it so that people actually care about Windows updates instead of just avoiding them. So yeah, that was my top 5 for the biggest changes coming with Windows 11. Just visually, I'm super excited to get this brand new modern look on my laptops. I think Windows is finally looking like an OS that people will want, and not just because they have to use it. The same goes for the usability side with the opening of the Microsoft Store. Windows is looking to be super friendly for developers, which will in the long run be a huge positive for users. Overall, I haven't been this excited for Windows in a long time, and I hope I'm not the only one. Windows 11 will be a free update and will officially come to eligible devices sometime around October of this year. But if you want to try it out early, you can do that today just by signing up for the Windows Insider program. Alright, thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and stay tuned for much more Windows 11 videos on this channel, and I'll see you guys on the next one.